Yusuf and his two older siblings counted themselves lucky. Their dad, a radiographer at the local hospital in Khan Yunis, had installed solar panels at their house. So even when their neighbourhood lost power, they could still watch their favourite cartoons. That's what they were doing when an airstrike hit from Israel. Miraculously, Yusuf's brother Hamid was unharmed. His sister Juri was found in the rubble. She was injured, but alive. Yusuf's mother searched in vain for her youngest son. She went to the hospital, asking if anyone had seen her handsome and curly-haired boy. It was Yusuf's dad who found him. His body had been taken to the morgue. Yusuf was 7 years old when killed. His dream was to be a doctor when he grew up. On his final day, he ran and hugged his dad before he left for work. Yusuf kissed me and said goodbye, his dad recalled. Madam Deputy Speaker, Yusuf is one of the more than 4,600 children and more than 11,000 Palestinians of all ages who have been killed in Israel's assault in Gaza. When the World Health Organization says a Palestinian child is being killed every 10 minutes, Yusuf was one of those 10 minutes. And Madam Deputy Speaker, behind every number you read, behind every horrifying statistic you hear, there were hopes and dreams, just as real, just as valuable as yours or mine. And I can't believe it has to be said, but it clearly does. Palestinian lives matter just as much as anyone else's. Israel's assault on Gaza has now killed one in every 200 Palestinians in the besieged enclave. Hospitals, ambulances and refugee camps have been targeted. Premature babies in incubators. Let me repeat that. Premature babies in incubators are dying today because hospitals have run out of fuel. In the illegally occupied West Bank, where Hamas is not in power, around 200 Palestinians have been killed by Israeli forces or armed settlers. Madam Deputy Speaker, we could spend all day listing the horrors which the likes of the United Nations Secretary General, Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch have said amount to clear violations of international humanitarian law and war crimes. The truth is, Israeli officials have been very open about their own intent. At the beginning of the assault, an Israeli military spokesperson said that the emphasis in bombing was on, and I quote, damage, not accuracy. A former head of the National Security Council said, and again I quote, that the aim was to make Gaza a place where no human being can exist. This weekend, an Israeli government minister said that the war, and again I quote, would be Gaza's Nakba, a reference to the 1948 catastrophe where hundreds of thousands of Palestinians were forcibly expelled from their homelands and never allowed to return. Madam Deputy Speaker, none of this is to downplay Hamas's appalling killing of Israeli civilians. I condemned that already, and I do it again today, and I repeat the calls for the release of all hostages. But like the UN Secretary General said, none of those crimes excuse what we have seen since. And unlike those crimes, Israel's assault on Gaza has been done with this government's unequivocal support and complicity, and almost certainly with British-made arms. I can see smirking happening on the front bench. Don't think it's a laughing matter, personally speaking. So when the government refuses to support a ceasefire, it gives Israel the green light to continue its slaughter of innocent Palestinians. When it refuses to support a ceasefire, it is refusing to push back against Israeli politicians and policies that aim to ethnically cleanse Palestinians from their lands. And Madam Deputy, Mr. Deputy Speaker, I am horrified, utterly horrified, that after all of this, members of this House are still willing to give Israel the green light, proposing nothing more than humanitarian pauses. There is nothing humanitarian about letting children eat a little today, only to bomb them tomorrow. The only humanitarian way forward is an immediate ceasefire, as has been recognised from everyone, from the Pope to the President of France, as well as 76% of the British public, according to polling. So to members across this House, I say this. The children killed in Gaza today could have been saved by a ceasefire agreed yesterday. So I urge you, I implore you, we will be remembered for this vote. So let's be on the right side of history and vote for a ceasefire today.
Amen.